Well, Gina, local expert says this earthquake in Japan is very complex, and there were some signs that something big was going to happen.
I mean, you can see the Philippine plate, the Eurasian plate.
Plymouth State University professor Dr. Marianne McGarry has been studying earthquakes for 30 years, but she's never seen anything like what shook Japan on Friday.
8.9 is the largest earthquake in recorded history in Japan, probably one of the largest earthquakes on the planet.
Dr. McGarry says that this massive quake was preceded by about 100 smaller earthquakes, or foreshocks, over the last 3 days.
This one was coming. It was surprising that there were so many foreshocks. That you don't always have foreshocks with an earthquake, but in this one you did.
Takumetsu is a senior at Plymouth State and has family in Yokohama, about 400 miles from the area's hardest hit by the earthquake. He says he's been able to email his parents and grandparents, and everyone is fine, but he feels for those affected.
I'm just sad. I can't do anything from here. What I can do is just to make sure if they're all safe.
The images of the destruction, both from the quake and the following tsunami, are overwhelming. Dr. McGarry says even though Japan is one of the most earthquake-ready places in the world, nothing could withstand this level of natural power.
With that amount of shaking, things are just going to be bad news in Japan because they're one of the most sophisticated countries in the world in terms of earthquake preparedness and research, but when you have that much shaking, 100 earthquakes in 3 days, you just are weakening the infrastructure.
Dr. McGarry says Japan can expect more earthquakes and perhaps even more tsunamis in the coming days. Reporting live, I'm Andy Hirschberger, WMUR News 9.